Swift song Style, and Dominic Sherwood won millions of hearts when he appeared in the video clip for it. But it's as an actor in the sci-fi series Shadowhunters that has made the Brit a superstar. And Dom is currently in the country and he joins us on the couch now. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. Yeah, it's great. I really appreciate being here. You're spending your time with silly old me. That's lovely.
Oh, please. tell us about the Taylor Swift video clip and how it all came about.
Taylor and I had known each other for a little while through my friend at the time, my girlfriend now, Sarah, had introduced us. And just kind of out of the blue, she texted me and said, hey, would you ever be interested in doing a music video? And I was like, well, for who? Like, it's like, be less vague with me. Just show me, like, right. Give me a little more. And she was like, for me. And I was like, yep. Yeah. Okay, yeah, yep, absolutely. And that was it. 2 weeks later, I was out in LA filming with Taylor.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now, you say you always wanted to be an actor.
Yeah.
But there are a lot of stunts in Shadowlands. I mean, have you ever injured yourself?
Yeah. Yeah. I got a tooth knocked out and I did.
Which one?
This one.
Is that a real tooth?
It's no.
They've done a great job.
They did. It's half and half now. Yeah. I got kicked in the face. And just out it
Such
came.
So are you going to still do your
I know,
stunts?
Well, that's very sweet of you. I do, yeah, I do as much as I can. And then I tore one of my ankles as well, I mean, so that was
it's
pretty tough.
It's fun to do stunts.
It is.
Especially if you're an athletic person. You want to do it all yourself, so
yes,
it is
as
great.
As much as you can. There are a couple that they're like, absolutely, like, there's no way we're going to let you jump, like, 30 feet off a building. And I was like, come on. Nope, no way.
Are they into one of those big airbags? You could do it.
No, they don't. They eat cardboard boxes now.
That's what
they jump into, cardboard boxes.
Yeah,
because they're designed to collapse underneath you. Yeah. And they're safer because airbags apparently can have problems every now and then. Either way, they didn't let me do it.
Right.
They just said flat
either
out,
way,
no.
It would have hurt.
Exactly, especially if I got it wrong. And, you know, after, like, losing a tooth and breaking an ankle, they were like, let's not make this a third strike. We'll keep you safe. That's all we need.
Now, you starred in the movie Vampire Academy. And
that's right.
That sort of helped you get introduced to your now girlfriend.
That's right, yes.
Who's in Modern Family.
Correct.
And she's gorgeous.
But who does she play?
She plays Hayley Dunphy, the eldest of the sisters in the Dunphy family.
She's gorgeous. How long have you been together?
2 years.
And where do you live?
LA.
LA, so you're both living in LA.
Both in LA with our two dogs.
Two doggies.
Oh,
what sort of doggies?
We have a Maltese poodle and a lab.
And you both have matching tattoos, right? Over the line.
We have similar tattoos,
similar.
That we got at the same time. They're both arrows.
Look at here. You're gone in for the kiss and she's got a bit embarrassed there, didn't
she? Yeah, she just likes to embarrass me. That's all that is. That's basically our entire relationship. That's like a perfect parallel for our relationship.
She's so gorgeous. And look at what a great couple they are.
Very cute.
You'd make
great.
Lovely very babies.
Right, too young.
Sure.
You can wait a couple
You've
years.
Got time.
Yeah.
Sarah, if you're watching. No, I'm kidding.
But does it help that you're both in, like, you know, really hit series?
Yeah,
does it help?
No, I actually think sometimes that can make it a lot harder because I film in Toronto and she films in LA and we end up separate for a lot of the time that we're supposed to be together, so it can be really hard. It can be hard work.
No, but it seems
you
know, working.
It said you've got a lot of David Bowie about you because you've got two different coloured eyes.
Yeah, that's right.
When you looked in the barrel and just your eyes are so pretty.
Let's have a look. There's like seven cameras in front of me.
And the lovely lady just going, that one.
Look at that
look
one.
At
there
that.
It is.
Can we zoom in on your eyes? So you've got a green and a blue.
A blue and a brown.
A blue and a brown.
A blue and a brown.
Is that unusual?
Yeah, relatively.
How many people ask you if you have a contact lens in?
All the time.
I'm sure.
And I'm like, I'm not that proud that I would every day put in one contact lens. It's like half a colour or whatever. No, it's just
what makes you different.
So one of your parents have one colour and the other?
No, and this is like a running family joke that I'm the adopted one because my family, as far back as we go, have blue eyes. As far back as so all of my brothers are like, yeah, well, that clearly means you're the adopted one. And I'm like, cheers, guys. That's grand. Good to see you.
But how many people in the world have different colour eyeballs?
I don't know. I've not met all the people in the world.
Kate Bosworth has it,
and you hear rumours about. I think Simon Pegg has it, and Henry Cavill has it a tiny bit. Like you hear rumours about different people have it in like different shades and different versions of it, and this, that, and the other. And it's a condition called iridium heterochromia, which is basically a fluctuation in the cones in your eye. This is really boring. I'm sorry.
No, it's not. It makes you more talented.
I'm sorry,
you could say anything.
I could.
Yeah.
But yes, it's when I was born, my eyes, both of my eyes were blue, and it grew into my eye and stopped when I was about 20.
Oh wow! Yeah. I wouldn't know which eyeball to look in, you know, because
neither do I.
It kind of draws you differently.
Yeah, it does.
We used to have an actor here that had one eye.
Mm-hmm. Just one eye?
No. He had a sort of funny, a glass eye or something.
Got ya.
And if you're acting with him, you didn't know which eye to look into. Yeah. So you used to look at his nose.
Right in the middle, right in the middle. Yeah. I wonder how many people do that with me. Is that what's happening now?
Yeah.
You looking right at my nose? Is that cool?
Which eye do you look at?
Yeah.
Hey, Shadowhunters is a fantastic cast, and one of your co-stars is the Old Spice guy.
That's right, yeah, Isaiah.
Is he so cool?
He's the coolest human being I've ever met in my entire life.
Yeah?
Yeah, like Isaiah has... There he is. Look at him.
Oh, wow.
I'd marry him in a heart.
Do you wear Old Spice because of him?
Yeah, like, we'll turn up and our trailer's just full of, like, Old Spice stuff, and I was like, Isaiah's been here. Isaiah's been here already.
Yeah. Now, you, first time to Australia, departing very soon.
Yeah.
What have you loved best about it? We love hearing this from people who visit.
So, I actually flew out to surprise a friend of mine who's over there. Hi, Daz.
Oh.
Nice. Who we used to live together, so we've been best friends for years. And I flew out to surprise him. I think one of my favourite things was getting to the hotel and just having the view of the harbour.
Yeah.
Just really beautiful and so iconic for Sydney. It was really great. So that was kind of my first big, like, oh, wow, I'm actually in Sydney. This is amazing.
Great place to honeymoon.
Uh-huh. Yeah, great.
Now, listen, if this show was going another hour, we'd have you married by then.
To either Sarah or Isaiah, yeah, one of the two.
I think I've tormented you enough this morning. You can catch the new season of Shadowhunters on Netflix. Dominic Sherwood, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you.